And now we'd like to show you how powerful this data can be when it's put to work, the data that we just heard about. The Red Cross is in the house and launched a hurricane app last month that offers people real-time data on what to do before, during, and after a hurricane. The app had over 100,000 downloads in the first 2 weeks. And today, Dominick Tolli, VP of Product Management for the Red Cross, will give us an overview of the Hurricane app and announce the launch of a new app that uses USGS data. So please welcome Dominick Tolli. Dominick? If Dominick is here, of course. Dominick?
Yeah.
Oh, dude! Come on stage, man.
Hi, Datapalooza people. Dom Tolli from the American Red Cross. And you probably know the Red Cross as the folks that come during big natural disasters. Hurricane hits, Red Cross goes running in while other people go running out and give people food and shelter and help them through the storm and then after the storm. There's a couple other things that the Red Cross does that I just want to let you know about and kind of takes the picture of how this fits in. So in addition to those big national disasters, we respond to about 70,000 disasters a year. About 90% of those disasters are home fires or apartment fires. While it's certainly not as newsworthy as a hurricane or an earthquake, to the families that get affected, they are disasters. So the Red Cross is there for those folks to be able to help them, obviously, after the fire, get them back on their feet, get them shelter, get them food, and get them moving again. In addition, the Red Cross supplies about 40% of the nation's blood supply. So people who need blood, 40% of that blood comes through the Red Cross from volunteers, and then it goes to the people that need it. Almost there. The Red Cross also has a division where we train people in first aid, and where we give information out to people to try to get them through emergencies and disasters. We call that bucket preparedness, so trying to get people that information when they need it is critical to what we're trying to do. Now, traditionally, that information has been handed out through classroom settings, how to get ready for a hurricane. Traditionally, that's been handed out through paper, so we hope we give somebody the piece of paper. We hope they hang on to it. We know a lot of them throw it out the doors or heading out back home. So we know they don't have that information when they need it. So we know there's a gap there. We have all this wonderful information that's been scientifically vetted that we want to get into the hands of people for emergencies. And the mobile channel is the way by which we're now starting to attack that problem. With 55 to 60% smartphone penetration here in the United States, the platform is there, the table has been set. Given the fact that we all know that people, even though they say they want to be prepared, they won't do anything until they absolutely have to, which makes mobile a great channel because it's on demand. So getting that information to them when they need it, where they need it very quickly, makes mobile a perfect channel for us to take the information that we traditionally been giving out and give it to them in a new way for that. So in June of this year, we launched our first aid app, which takes the concept of everyday first aid concepts and gives people what to do in case of an emergency that we hear the most that they experience every day. It's available on both the Apple and the Android platforms. And the first thing you'll notice when you open it up, it gives emergency guidance, right? The Red Cross is very good at when things go really bad, being able to tell people what they need to do. So the first thing you notice in the app is if it's an emergency, we give very clear direction on what to do. We're not trying to teach you anything. We're just trying to give you very clear direction on the steps you need to take. So we have, can't walk away. So we have very specific steps for a whole host of emergency everyday, we call everyday first aid scenarios that people can then click on. As you can see, if it's bleeding, we don't fool around and say, bleeding is caused by your cut. We just say, look, put pressure on it. And we also integrate the capability to call 911. Now, while technology-wise, people go, what's amazing is when things go bad and people are under pressure, they forget everything. You get tunnel vision, you start to panic, and the thing that's in all the first aid classes with the first aid is someone please call 911. So the fact that you have a button there, the fact that you don't have to get out of the app, the fact that it's in your face and it's there to call 911, we think is fantastic. And really, actually, we've gotten some pretty high marks for it because it's just something you forget. You immediately start helping. So integrating that is great. While, again, it's not technologically a huge step forward, it's certainly one that takes into account the environment and what the customer is currently going through. Now, we do have a learn section, so if it's not an emergency, you can have a more browsing experience and learn about what to do during the first aid. And we'll take you through it, we'll give you videos, we'll show you diagrams for it. So in a more relaxed environment, we're trying to learn first aid through the app. The most amazing thing is we have this ability to test oneself. This is the most popular feature of the application, which is amazing to me, because if you were to tell me that the most popular feature would be somebody would be taking a test on an app, I wouldn't believe it. But it's true. It is by far and above the most used portion of the app. And that's great, because that means people are trying to learn it and trying to really get good at the first aid. Now, I think because we wrap it around social, we allow you to earn badges, we allow you to share those badges, we try to make that learning fun. And by doing that, we're finding people, to a great extent, using the app to test themselves, that they know the first aid, they know what to do in these. And they earn the badges, they put them on their Facebooks, they tweet them out. And it's great, because that gets other people saying, well, what is that? And then other people download the app and hopefully keep some of the viral stuff going. So that's the first aid app. We've also, and that launched in June, and then in August, we launched the hurricane app. Again, what we're trying to do is get critical information into the hands of people when they need it. Now, again, people will do practically nothing until they absolutely have to. So instead of me trying to change their behavior, I'm just going to go with it. So we have the hurricane app, and we put several key features we're going to take you through, and they're going to take you through what happened during Hurricane Isaac. So one of the most important pieces is the preparedness information, right? The information that you need to give people on what to do during a hurricane. Again, we know that they're not going to do anything well before it, so the first tab is right before. We know the hurricane's coming. We know you just downloaded a day or two before, so we're giving you the steps they need to do. And a real breakthrough for us is being able to prioritize that information and saying things like, if you do nothing else, do these four steps. That'll get you 60% of the way there. And then once you get those four steps, do these next four steps. That'll get you another 10% of the way there. So it's really giving people clear direction on what they need to do in each phase as they're going through the storms, whether it's before, during, or after, or well after. They can get ready for the next one, is doing that and saying that. We give related links. So as you're learning that, if you want to, you're going to experience potential power outages. If the power goes out, there's more information. We tried to give it related information so that people kind of have a whole solution and what to do before and during a hurricane. Oh, wrong way. I'm really going the wrong way. Uh-oh, I've broken something. Hurricane. Here we go. The next function is people want to be alerted, right? So we have the capability for people to monitor their locations and set any locations that is monitored by NOAA. And this is where our great partnership with NOAA came in, because they deliver this information through their API. It enables us to take that information and share it with individuals. So you can monitor your location. In the hurricane app, we give obviously hurricane warnings, watches. We give tornadoes. We give floods. We give storm warnings and watches. All that information comes from those locations. And this is good not only for the location you're in, but we have a number of people who are not in hurricane areas, but their family is, or their parents are. So they can monitor those locations, get the alerts, and then be able to help those people remotely, being able to say, now get out and stop joking around this time. We also have worked with the Weather Channel to provide a weather tracker information. People want to be alerted. They want to know, where's the storm, and is it coming after me? So being able to provide that information is also vital to the folks. And then we also provide a capability called I'm Safe. So that allows people to broadcast out. They don't need us to do it, but they can broadcast an I'm Safe message or any personalized message they can do. And they can broadcast it out from here, to Twitter, to their Facebook, if they want to keep it more personal, to SMS, or send it to their email contacts on their phone. What was interesting about this was during Hurricane Isaac is the ratio was that the average number of recipients reached for each one going out was about 60. So people were using this as a broadcast mechanism to let 60 people know on average that, hey, I'm okay. Ah, damn it. So let me tell you about Hurricane Isaac, what happened. So exactly what I said. We launched it. We had a couple downloads. The really uber-prepared people were ready. And then the downloads go like this. And then Isaac starts to come. And all of a sudden, you see it's starting to head towards Puerto Rico. Boom, spiking in Puerto Rico. They start downloading the app like crazy. And then Florida, it's the next target. You see Florida light up. And you can see the whole Gulf region, from Florida going right across the Gulf, light up as the hurricane is coming and as it's changing force. From Florida all the way across to Texas, you see the downloads going through. Now, while they're doing that, they're going into the preparedness information. We know, because we can analyze it, that they're spending anywhere from 12 to 25 minutes reading that information, knowing what to do, and getting that information that before we wouldn't have been able to get to them in that time when they needed it. So really thrilled about that. Now the storm's coming. It keeps coming. They've set their alerts. Now this is where the partnership with NOAA is tremendous. Because during Hurricane Isaac, we sent through the app 2 million weather alerts came through that app and alerted people what was coming, whether it was the hurricane warning or watch or a storm or a flood. 2 million messages came through that app to those people for those locations they were monitoring. And that became, during the hurricane, that and being able to track the storm became the top areas that people were looking for in the application. As it was going through. So it just shows you the power of working with those with NOAA and those great organizations to be able to take that information and give it to people when they need it, where they need it, in a very compelling manner. As the storm passes, also in the app, we have the ability for people to view shelter locations. So to be able to look at where does Red Cross have shelters. So now people, they've gotten through the storm, obviously they're alive, but their house may not be in great shape, or they may need food or shelter, or maybe their friends or family needs food and shelter. And now they can go onto the app and get the most current shelter locations for the Red Cross, get its address, be able to get directions from the cell phone, and be able to help themselves for that. And that's how we envisioned it. So we're shocked it actually happened that way. But we're very happy to see that those actions were taken by the customers. They got ready. The weather alerts came, then they got help by finding the shelter applications through it. So we were real thrilled to have that partnership and be able to use that data for that. We'd also like to announce, now I just got earthquake. So we're announcing we're coming out with an earthquake app. Now we're hoping this doesn't mean an earthquake is coming like we did with the hurricane. But again, it's going to have the same characteristics that we're having within the hurricane app. So it's going to have the capability for alerting. It's going to have the all the steps you need to take before, during, and after an earthquake. Again, we're working with the USGS now to take their alerts, the earthquake alerts, into the application to be able to show for those locations that you're at and those locations you want to monitor, we'll send you those earthquake notifications. You'll be able to set a couple different parameters on what type you want to see and what the magnitude of that is. Again, people who remotely have family in California, I live up in Jersey, family in California, it'd be good to know what's going on out there and then be able to know that right through my cell phone and have a push notification come out with that. In addition, we use other data from the USGS to be able to help show people what is the magnitude of the earthquake and kind of what was the intensity. I'll try to help simplify people what they're looking at for that. So really excited about that. We're announcing that today. That's going to start flowing next week for that. And we're thrilled about it. So thanks for the data enabling it to go through. Thanks.